Welcome back, everyone. Today is Home Theater Room Tours episode 34, featuring a magnificent 7.2.4 Triad surround sound setup. We'll be also taking a closer look at one of the most luxurious basements on this channel. So grab a drink, turn up the volume, because there's a ton of useful information and inspiration in this epic video. We've finally settled into our rental home until our new home gets built. This is my office slash recording studio for the time being, which I'm still moving things around and trying to resolve a bit of the echo in the room, but that's a whole new another video. Let's dive into this beautiful space, which belongs to Alex from Atlanta, United States. Alex is a corporate strategist for a technology company who's always been a massive fan of movies ever since he was little. And since basements are a common space in Atlanta, he grew up spending a lot of time around his friends' basements and knew one day he will achieve the goal of his life. Him being a family of four now, he wants to share and inspire a lot of you guys and welcomes a lot of their friends that's in the neighborhood for movies, drinks, and hangouts. You, my friend, are a top bloke. Let's check it out. So this house was built in 2015 with an unfinished 1800 square feet basement. In 2018, Alex and his family bought this property and blueprinted to have a home theater, big bar area, a gym, large open living space, bedroom, a bathroom, and a storage area. Without going into too much detail, let's take a short walkthrough of what the basement looks like now and then head over to the home theater room. To the left of this video is the enclosed gym that's surrounded in half-inch glass with big entrance doors and black fittings overlooking the backyard. Decent amount of space for a good workout. It also features two Triad ceiling speakers connected through a Sonos amplifier in the AV rack, which we'll take a look at in a few moments. Wow, guys, I'm really loving this lounge area. The color combination of the walls, furniture, and cabinetry gold fittings are screaming sexy. And that spectacular ceiling fan looks divine in the middle of the recessed ceiling feature. Truly feels luxurious, and that U-shaped lounge looks so inviting. Could imagine myself watching the game on that 75-inch LG TV with a Sonos beam for a bit of kick in audio. As we spin around, the glass barn door looks so unique, and then is the ultimate bar of the neighborhood. Ooh wee, I mean, let's take a step back and appreciate the high quality craftsmanship. All of these cabinets are custom built, the leather bar stools and lights continuing the gold class vibe. And since Alex is a massive whiskey and bourbon fan, he's stocked up until the year 2050. When you're in here, Alex says nothing is off limits, but on the other hand, his wife loves her wine. So check out this epic 260 bottle storage area behind a 3/4-inch glass door that is not temperature controlled. Of course, a sub-zero fridge and a dishwasher is a must in this impressive space, but one thing I seem to be blown away by is this glass rinser. That is a game changer. Okay, that's enough of the basement tour. Let's talk home theater. So this space measured at 23x13 with a 9-foot ceiling. Just like every brand new build, carpentry of walls and ceiling went up. Framed a 4-inch tray ceiling for recessed up lighting feature around the room. Installed a 9-inch riser for second row seating. And of course, fitted conduit inside the walls for all speaker cables, power points, switches, and lighting. Next step was the HVAC system that got a little tricky thanks to the floor joists and plumbing pipes for upstairs. But once this was completed, insulated the walls and ceiling with Rockwool insulation and covered it with acoustic Soundbreak XP 5/8-inch drywall, leaving two things till the finish line. One was to paint the entire basement graphic charcoal color, which I think looks really nice. And secondly, the flooring, which he chose to go with the Stanton woven carpet in the home theater that feels nice on the feet. Jumping into the audio of the room, this Triad 7.2.4 setup is so underrated. And starting from the front for left, center, and right channels, we have the Triad in-wall 6 LCR speakers offering outstanding fidelity on movies and music. The surround and back speaker choice is a little bit different, which are the Triad in-wall Silver 4 surround speakers, filling the room with vivid, lifelike sound, taking your experience to a whole new level. The dipole design looks phenomenal, delivering powerful output levels with the chosen drivers and components. Up above for an immersive overhead experience, Alex has hooked up four Triad Silver 6 sat in-ceiling Dolby Atmos speakers. These two-way unique recessed 35-degree angled baffle directs sound at the listener through the acoustic perf grille that can be custom painted to match the ceiling color. For some serious punch, I think two Triad in-room Omnisub 12s are a perfect match for delivering powerful bass performance of -3B at 17 Hz thanks to its 500 watt Class D amplifiers. I'm sure they sound very impressive and I personally love the overall look of this subwoofer. Let's take a quick detour and check out what's powering this beautiful setup. The dedicated AV room is located behind the reseats in a separate little room, which I think is a great idea to save space and eliminate noise in the home theater. The entrance of the AV rack room is located just outside the home theater double door entrance, but Alex is using the Strong FS series AV rack with DC fans, and starting from the top, we have the famous rack mounted Control 4 entertainment and automation controller paired with the Control 4 SR260 remote, simplifying and modernizing the experience in this room that controls audio and video equipment, along with four of these unique black metal mesh and gold wall lights and RGB ceiling strip lights on two Control 4 keypad dimmers that just looks unreal. Underneath is the 110 series Arachnus Network 16-port gigabit switch with rear ports. On the side, he's also hooked up the 800 series Wattbox IP power conditioner and Orbi mesh Wi-Fi system, filtering, protecting, and boosting the entire network system of this space. Moving down is a Roku and Apple TV 4K streaming devices, which is a common choice in many home theater rooms. But of course, every home theater should have a physical media player, and this Sony UBPX 800 M2 Ultra HD 4K player is another fine unit for the money. And here we have the playmaker of the room, the almighty 11.2 channel Denon AVRX 6700H 8K receiver, which is also capable of running a 13.2 channel setup paired with an additional amplifier. And lastly, the bottom Sonos amplifier is for the Triad speakers in the gym room that I mentioned earlier. As you can see, there is a lot of space in the AV rack for future additional amplification and other units, so if you guys have any suggestions, shoot a comment down below. Heading back to the theater room, for display, Alex has chosen to go with the 133-inch Dragonfly 16.9 acoustically transparent Ultra Acoustic Weave screen, which features a finely woven fiberglass material that transmits crystal clear audio through the screen to create the ultimate cinematic experience. Of course, a room like this deserves a treat. A projector that lets you be in the movie, and this IMAX enhanced Sony VPL VW295ES, I think, is the perfect fit that's held up high with the strong fine adjust toolless projector mount. I think next gen HDR gaming would look stunning with its eye popping colors and contrast levels with no visible banding. For seating, we have a total of 7, 2 rows of Palliser Audio space-saving theater seats with a touch of brass, cup holders, and USB ports, keeping the gold flowing throughout the entire basement. These seats look comfortable. Of course, they're powered recliners, powered foot and headrests for that extra comfort. For decor, there's really not much in this room, and I kind of like the clean, minimal vibe, which makes the room feel a lot bigger, more inviting, and professional. In this basement build process, Alex ran a couple of speaker cables from the AV rack to the backyard just in case of any future plans. And since now he's completed his lounge and home theater room, he plans to transform his backyard to an entertainer's delight by adding a swimming pool and a couple of speakers to have parties that we all live for. Alex wanted to create a modern, luxurious vibe with them blacks, charcoal, and gold colors with leather bar stools and seats. I think they'll work together really nicely, and since he has his family and friends over most of the time, he wanted to make sure there's enough space for everyone, the adults watching the game in the bar area or chilling in the lounge room somewhat relaxing while the kids take over the home theater room. But since I don't drink much, I think I'll be joining the kids. Well, that's it for another home theater room tour. If you guys have any suggestions or questions, you know what to do in the comment section down below. Show some love and support by clicking on that like button, which will help the performance of this video big time. A huge shout out to my fellow Patreons. You guys are awesome. And if you'd like to become a massive HStudio 3.0 fan, you can do so for as low as $3 a month, which will be pumped back into the growth of the channel, creating more and better content for you guys with some potential future giveaways and much more. Thank you for watching. And if you want to chat, you can catch me on Instagram, Facebook, and my Discord server. Stay tuned, God bless, and I'll see you guys soon. Peace.